Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 27, Gender and Social Stratification. In most societies, the tasks of women are clearly differentiated. In the West as well as in the middle class sections of Indian society, men have been seen to be the breadwinners, and women are expected to take care of the house and raise children. This arrangement used to be considered as natural and complementary, having roots in the biological makeup of sexes. The economic dependence of women and sexual division of labor were closely interlinked. The ideology of naturalness of division of labor has been challenged as women started entering the labor force in large numbers in the West. The rise of feminist movement in the West raised questions about the division of labor and almost universal subordination of women across societies and cultures. The questions like, has employment changed women's status? Are they facing double burden of performing jobs which are negatively valued? For example, housework not being considered as work, whereas paid work outside the household as work. Statistics show that women all over the world earn much less than men for the same work. Occupations are also segregated along gender lines. Other questions relate to women's active participation in workforce is its consistent devaluation and women's exclusion from the decision making. In understanding these issues, we look for answers in the stratification theories. Feminist scholars resist to treat the problem of women essentially an artifact of the complementary system of economic exploitation. They have argued that the oppression of women is not to be seen and secondary to class oppression as a whole. Women are oppressed as a class by men, and patriarchal structures are geographically and historically almost universal. The major axis of differentiation in prevailing society is not class but gender, and it is women who wait for the longest revolution. Gender in class stratification theories attempts to uncover the sources of structured inequality and social change. Both Marxists and the Weberians have been engaged in empirical research, which both document and attempt to explain the forms of structures of inequality. It has been widely criticized that the class situation of family members is derived from that of the main breadwinner, who is usually a man. The question of gender raises serious problems for both theoretical and the empirical work in social stratification. The active participation of women in all walks of life, the decrease in the number of households that have only male breadwinners, passage of new laws created an environment for women's location in social stratification. According to Newby, the issue of gender inequality arose from women's movement. Now let us move to the next point, Weber, Marx and stratification. Weber observed that societies can be stratified according to their degree for class or status formation, providing the most important and basic fact of social stratification theory. The first form of inquiry concerns with the extent to which class or status systems are the predominant modes of social action at the societal level. Theories of social stratification then presuppose, as their explanatory object, the inter and intra-societal variability of class or status formations. At this time, the question of sexual inequality is being treated in terms of division of labor, which considers women as reserve army. The labor of women could be called upon to facilitate expansionary deskling, clerk work, as well as in the periods of acute labor shortage, such as in wartime. According to Max Weber, economic and technological changes favor class stratification and pushes status stratification in the background. Such a determination and explanation of the variability of class and status formation have been the central concerns of the study of social stratification. The documentation of the inequality of opportunities and outcome occupied a subordinate place. It was justified on several grounds. First, because of interest in the disturbance of unequal rewards, life chances, and how different social arrangements could procure better outcomes and opportunities. The second reason was the importance given to the explanation of outcomes of the class or status differentiation, which were considered as byproduct of the stratification analysis. These approaches never gave serious thought to issue of gender inequality, because the emphasis was on class polarization and status group consolidation. Earlier, it was always presumed that the gender relations are usually heterosexual and therefore cross-cut by class and status relations. It gave bearing on the view that the gender relations are somehow similar to ethnic relations. Patriarchy constitutes a type of social formation that has been improperly ignored by conventional stratification analysis. According to Mann, the omission of gender as a basis of social stratification created a crisis in the stratification theory. The five main areas of stratification theory which have been influenced by gender are individual, the family and household, the division of labor between the sexes, social class, and nation states. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.